Republicans are kind of freaking out right now, a little bit still, from what happened last week in Kansas. Kansas, of course, a deep red state that has not voted for a Democrat since 1964, which is, by the way, still more recent than the area that I live in, but that's neither here nor there. Kansas is super conservative. But last week, on Tuesday, they overwhelmingly voted against an abortion ban that was on the ballot. So you had all of these conservatives that looked at this. They voted for conservatives and still voted against this abortion ban by double digits. Now, it was expected that that race, not race, but that vote was actually going to be close, you know, maybe within a couple of points either way. It was a double-digit victory. And now Republicans are freaking out. And they're doing everything they can to convince themselves, of course, that, oh, no, it's totally not what it seems. It's not as bad as we think it is. Here is what Matt Schlapp had to say. Because Schlapp believes, by the way, the problem is that the bill wasn't conservative enough, right? It's not that people didn't want it. It's that they wanted something even more fierce. So here's what he said. It was not a heartbeat bill. It was a late-term ban along with other basic regulations. With a pro-life governor, look for much stronger pro-life victory soon. A blip. That's right. The defeat of this amendment in Kansas was just a blip, folks. Don't worry. We don't worry about blips. Well, other Republican strategists and, of course, Republican lawmakers aren't exactly as optimistic. They are, of course, out there trying to convince people, hey, no reason to get upset. No reason to freak out now. We're totally cool. We just lost a very easy thing in a deep red state that should have gone our way, but it didn't. So, you know, everything's okay. Trust us. No, they're panicking on the inside. And they're panicking because they understand they knew this was going to happen. I don't think for a second that these Republicans could look at all the polling data showing that overwhelmingly this country supports Roe versus Wade, supports letting women have the right to choose what to do with their own bodies. Even those conservatives, they still want women to have that right. They don't want these old white Republicans to tell them what they can and cannot do. And these Republicans knew that. But they got a little too greedy. They thought that maybe there's a chance if we're going to get it, we're going to get it in a deep red state like Kansas. Didn't happen. So they know their goose is cooked. Now, whether or not this actually means the Democrats are going to cruise to easy victories in November, I don't think it means that. But I do think it means we are going to have more, you know, I guess we'll call them Roe voters than Republicans had banked on. And yes, that will hurt them in the midterms. It could hurt them in the primaries. And the more they try to double down on this, the more they act like this is the singular issue of the midterms, the more it's going to hurt them. So politically speaking, the smart thing they could do is just shut the hell up about it and move on with their day. But these are conservatives. You know, logic, reason, rationale doesn't ever come into their brains. So they're going to keep whining and crying about this, which of course is going to make it so much worse for them, which of course is probably the greatest thing that could happen. This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.